Wait, are all the presents that Santa can call?
Rocking around the Christmas tree at the Christmas party hop. Mistletoe hung where you can see.
They go around and around.
Roman, it's going to be so cool.
Oh.
Oh, London got shoes.
Voices singing, let's be jolly, deck the halls with boughs of holly, rocking around Christmas tree, have a happy holiday.
Oh, signs.
I know, I had to really practice to learn how to sign for him.
Look at the card.
How'd you get this?
Look at the card. That's why I had to say "and" from the dream team.
God in creation.
Yeah, that's from the Carvalhos.
Wow, Ellie. Man, look at
Ellie.
Your
hair is insane.
Whoa.
Hey.
Whoa. Throw
crap.
Stand on that side. Stand on that side.
Windsor, what is this? More ice cream.
This is Windsor's main present.
Nan, are you his first customer?
I'm his first customer. All right, baby, I'm gonna open this one.
From my beard. Yeah.
The spirit of the season.
Roman?
It's
Roman?
The Mater tow truck!
Your very own.
It's Mater! Oh my goodness!
The mood is right, the spirit's up, we're here tonight, and that's enough. Simply having a wonderful Christmas time. Simply having a wonderful Christmas time.
Olive.
It's all
inside.
Okay.
She knows.
I like it. I always wanted this thing.
Always?
Yeah.
All your life?
Daddy, look! What?
Roman, what do you got? Roman, don't shoot me. Did you shoot me with your...
Pull this one out.
Oh, you shot me! Bro, Spider-Man! Oh, you got me!
What is it, Daniel? Oh, clean underwear!
Pair of thieves.
Yes.
Pair of thieves.
Linden, do that to your mommy. Do that to your mommy.
I thought at first it was like a mask, so I could go, you know.
I got double. Uh-oh.
What is it, Danny?
Hey!
What is it?
It's a DNA test. Ancestry.
The word is out about the town. So lift your glass. Oh, don't look down. Simply having a wonderful Christmas time. The choir of children sing their song. They practiced all year long.
Bathtub.
It's a water baby, but she can play with her in the bathtub.
With love, Papa.
Yes.
Thank you, Mom. Oh my gosh.
Okay.
Come here.
There you go. This is what we need with all this.
Whoa.
There you go.
That's enough. We simply having a wonderful Christmas time. Simply having a wonderful Christmas time. Simply
having a wonderful Christmas time. Wood Monopoly.
Candyland.
Is this because we're
all
is this a
old?
Game?
Is this their game?
That's exactly
No, the theme is family time in your new house.
Get out of there!
Hello?
It's from Mikey and Bethany.
What the heck? No, because no, it's for you guys, from us.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
I just helped.
They only gave you the delivery. They were the keepers. We've been hiding them at their house since Thanksgiving.
Yeah.
Oh,
look at that.
Ellie, no. Put it back. No.
Look at these. Look. Are those two coffee and bars?
I don't know, we'll find out.
I don't know.
And here we are in Santa's workshop. And the elves are busy putting together all the Christmas presents.
It's my Christmas present!
And these are Santa's helpers.
So put put them all on there, okay? And they go in the fridge.
Micah, what are we having for Christmas breakfast?
Micah's famous Christmas tacos.
Oh, famous Christmas tacos.
World
famous.
Class.
World class.
Famous breakfast burritos.
So I hear rumor that Micah's in charge of breakfast and Nana's in charge of Christmas dinner.
Yes.
Okay.
We're gonna have prime rib.
Prime rib.
Loaded baked potato.
Loaded.
And we're gonna have roasted Brussels sprouts.
Roasted Brussels sprouts. Roman.
And our famous.
One more time, famous.
Not done. Famous. Sweet potato souffle.
Ooh, Papa is happy, happy, happy. And Roman loves sweet potato souffle, don't you?
Yeah. And I love frosting.
Was this the best Christmas ever?
Yeah. Oh, and I have a cake. Hello. I got a cake.
Oh, this was the best Christmas ever. So everybody's busy working. Find out what Grandpa Gene's doing. Grandpa Gene, how are you doing in here?
Fine.
Are you watching the kids play?
I'm serving the man with the ice cream stand.
Okay.
Hot dogs.
I don't want a lot for Christmas. There is just one thing I need. I don't care about the presents underneath the Christmas tree. I just want you for my own, more than you could ever know. Make my wish come true.
Just one thing I need,
and I
don't care about the.
Mommy, are you having a wonderful Christmas?
Yes. He's like, I want my own private gift opening.
I got a doll. And a book. I got this doll.
It's a book. ABC book.
ABC book.
And it's going to go in there. It goes in your link star.
Chapter 1, verse 11. It says, "For I long to see you, so that I may impart some spiritual gifts to you." I want to give you spiritual gifts. Now, this is the Apostle Paul, a natural man, giving to other people spiritual gifts, and that you may be established. And so, one of the things that I experienced as a child when I was growing up, periodically, my father, my mother, they would gather us children together on Christmas Eve or Christmas morning, and they would say to us spiritual gifts that they've identified. In the Bible, there's several passages of Scripture that lays out a whole myriad of spiritual gifts. And they would say, "Eddie, we've seen you doing this and doing this. These are spiritual gifts, and we want to pray for those gifts to flourish in your life." And that's what we did in both services this morning, and had our grandsons here. Come on over here, Romes. Windsor. Hi, buddy. I call him my little buddy, and Roman is my big buddy. And we all know London is princess. So, London Grace. Now, I want to show you quickly, every time London comes out, she lives in L.A., and every time she comes out to visit Nana and Papa, on Saturday night while I'm writing my Sunday morning message, she likes to be with me. So while everybody else is around the house doing whatever they're doing, she comes and she spends sometimes an hour, several hours with me. And I'll be sitting there working on the computer, and she's sitting there writing, and she writes a message as well. And earlier, if you were here at the huddle, at the 8:20 huddle this morning with all the leaders, London, she wrote it. And so she wrote her message. Already, Nana and Papa can see spiritual gifts in our grandchildren. We can see them. And for London, her spiritual gift, and we talked about this yesterday, didn't we, London? We see the gift of ministry, or the Bible also calls it the gift of serving. And here, London, your mommy, you may not know this, but your mommy, Bethany, and your Nana, and your great nanny, all have the gift of ministry and serving. Okay, so it just seems natural. But yesterday when I was sharing with London that she has clearly the gift of ministry and the gift of serving, she says, "Papa, would you please pray for me that I will also have," what did you say, baby?
Faith.
The gift of faith. She said, "I want the gift of faith." Why? Because Nana has a gift of faith. So it's natural. She just naturally wants the same gift that her Nana has. Now, how many of you know, of all the gifts I could give my grandchildren this Christmas, how many of you know, why not give them a gift that will last a lifetime? Roman has a gift of exhortation. A gift of exhortation or encouragement, the Bible calls it. And here you say, "Well, how do you know?" Well, Roman, yes, just yesterday, he said these words to his papa 5 or 6 times. He said, "Papa, you're so good at that." Did you say that? He said, "Papa, you're so good at that." And then he said, "Papa, you're the best at that." And then he said, then he tells me this when I was trying to work on a fan yesterday. He said, "Papa, you can do it." Literally, he just followed me around the house yesterday, encouraging me that I can do it. He's an encourager. Windsor, this one's pretty obvious too. Windsor, who's 2, Windsor has the gift of leadership. And here's why. There's 5 grandbabies. Well, there's 11 of us in the house this weekend. And Windsor says this at least 10 times yesterday. "Come on, guys, follow me." All the family, "Come on, guys, follow me. Come on, guys. Come, guys." What else did he say?
Yeah, no, no, Roro.
No, no, Roro. do this, Roro. No, Roro, we're doing this, Roro. He's got the gift of leadership. Some people call that the gift of bossiness. But we call it the gift of leadership. Father, we pray for London Grace, the gift of ministry, the gift of serving. We see already that she's so passionate about writing messages and sharing what she knows about the Bible and about Jesus. And she's asked for a gift of faith. And so, Father, I just pray, God, that you would just cause that gift to just be developed in her in a greater, greater way. Father, we pray for Roman. He's such an encourager. He's such an exhorter. He's so good at causing other people to feel better about themselves. And so, Father, I just ask that that gift just be manifested in his life. And, Father, through him encouraging others, he himself would be encouraged, that he would be an encouraged young man. And, Father, Windsor, Father, already we see leadership. And we just thank you for, as he continues to grow in his leadership, Father, I just thank you that you're going to cause him to be blessed. And Father, just help Nana and Papa to just steward these gifts. Amen, amen, amen. Oh, last thing, London wanted to share her message with you. So, London, you want to read this?
God loves me. God loves you. God gave us a present. It is not about presents. It is about God.
Good job, London. One of the things I've noticed with little Emma is that she clearly has a gift of faith. She believes, she's positive, she has an excitement, and she's believing the best. And Emma, you may not know this, but your grandma, Nana has a gift of faith. And so it makes sense that the gift of faith is showing up in her granddaughters, amen? And it's a wonderful gift. I think Ellie has the gift of generosity. And because Ellie will literally give you anything that she has. She tried to give me her lunch several times yesterday. And so other than this little binky right here, she doesn't have the gift of generosity when it comes to her binky. She wants that. Yeah, okay. And let's pray. Can we pray for my granddaughters, our granddaughters? Father, we just pray for little London. And we see such a gift of ministry, and her and Emma have desired the gift of faith. So, Father, I just pray that they would have such faith that they can believe God and that they can see miracles in their lifetime. And, Father, for little Ellie, generosity or whatever their gifts are, and Ellie would have the gift of faith. Father, I just pray that this Christmas they would have such an understanding, such a knowledge that you love them and you have a plan for their lives. And everyone said, amen. Thank you, girls. Thank you for helping Papa preach tonight.